shoulders upright, so I offer you, please let me know.
Good morning to the pulpit, to the choir, to the family of Tom Lewis. When all of the Zangwill's chums and moms, please stand at this moment. We, the members of the Zangwill's chapter of Chums Incorporated, extend to our chum sister family, to daughters Tiffany and Tina, and all the beautiful grandchildren, our sincere, and the rest of the family, I'm sorry, I didn't call your name, but the rest of the entire family.
Amen.
We extend our heartfelt sympathy on the passing of our dear home, Lewis Williams. Lewis was a selfless man who went through his entire life helping others. He was a caregiver for his family and others in need. He had empathy for others and made sure the widows within the Chum chapter would be recognized on special occasions. He would send them flowers. He would organize, as Barry said before, the dinner theater for Mother's Day so that we all could enjoy that. He would do all things for us just to make life a little bit better. When my husband was sick, he would always call and say, "How is my buddy? I will miss that." He was an adventurous person who loved life. He loved exploring new places and traveling with his lovely wife and his daughters. Lewis thought of himself as a good cook, and he was. He loved to entertain and would invite you months in advance of the event. He would call and say, "Please hold the date." And then later he would call, send a written invitation, and he still would call to remind you of the date. "Lewis, I'm going to miss that. In fact, we're scheduled to go to a party on the 28th of December. Unfortunately, we won't be able to do that." But we were advised well in advance. He always believed in dressing to impress, and he would let you know that if you were invited to his place, he expected that of you. And if you knew him, as others have said, he was always well-dressed and well-coordinated, whatever the occasion. We are very, very thankful for the moment of happiness and the moment of sadness that we had the privilege to share with Tom Lewis. We are truly grateful for the memories he leaves with all of us. We love him, and we will miss him. To the family, we are here for you. We are only a phone call away. Please call us. And Beverly, I have a message from the national organization as well. They want you to know that they too love you. And before I go to my seat, I would like to read a poem by Ralph Waldo Emerson that sums up Lewis's life, in my opinion. And it says, "To laugh often and much, to win the respect of intelligent people and the affection of children, to earn the appreciation of honest critics and endure the portrayal of false friends, to appreciate beauty, to find the best in others, to leave the world a bit better, whether by a healthy child, a garden patch, or redeemed social conditions. To know even one life has breathed easier because you have lived, this is to have succeeded." We will miss you, Lewis. Rest.